Hey everybody, I'm Jason Yoder. Welcome to my channel, and today we are going to be talking about the element of photography called symmetry. Now I'm standing out here on this pier in a snowstorm just to show you the element of symmetry. Essentially, it's going to be balancing the image by mirroring elements on each side or top or bottom or all around. So what we're going to do is we're going to head back to a warmer spot and we're going to go over some images that reflect symmetry. Okay, now we are in a much warmer place. Now guys, I apologize if you hear some wind noise because it's really windy out there. But what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at some images that involve symmetry. Now really what we're trying to do here is to make a separation from a snapshot and a photograph. So a snapshot would be when all of a sudden you see something, you pull out your phone and you take a picture. All right, it's just to capture what's happening right there at that time, but you're really not creating a compelling image. You need to take a look at the rules of composition to create those compelling images, to create those images that people want to look at, that they're drawn to. Now, there's many different rules, and we're going to be covering symmetry in this particular video. So let's go back to that pier I was just standing on. Now, take a look at this image. We do not have symmetry. If you draw a line vertically down the screen, the left and the right do not mirror each other. You can see on the left, the railing of the pier makes a 90 degree turn. So it's really kind of awkward to look at. Now let's look at it from a different perspective. I move forward in this image and you can see now that I have, if you draw a vertical line down the left and right hand side, or down the middle of this image, you're gonna see the left and the right are mirroring each other. Now there's another element, another rule of composition called leading lines that are coming into play to help enhance the image. But in this case, though, looking at it from a symmetric point of view, it's pretty good. All right, let's go to Naples, Italy. Now, in Naples is where I came across Castel Nuovo. I hope I pronounced that right. This is a medieval castle in the middle of the city along the waterfront. And it's the first castle I ever saw in Europe. So when you take a look at this picture, when you exclude the fact that the tower to the right is a bit darker because of shadow than the one on the left, we pretty much can draw a line down the middle and have symmetry. The two arches in the main entryway are symmetric. You can see down the lower third, we have columns, two columns on each side. So we pretty much have achieved symmetry. Now with man-made objects, you're going to have a good chance of achieving symmetry, but not always. Let's step back a little ways from the castle and take a look at it now. Now that we've stepped away from the castle, you can see that architecturally there are differences on the left and the right of the main entryway. So we've lost symmetry. Now we almost have a rule composition called the rule of threes, in which you have three identical elements. You can see in the foreground we have three very dominant dark towers. They are kind of disrupted a little bit by the main entryway. Does not, between the center and right tower, does not match what's between the left and center tower. And also if you look in the back right, there's another tower. So we almost had another good element of composition, but this is not as pleasing to look at because things just don't balance out well. Now let's take a look inside the Galleria Umberto I. And again, this is another place inside of Naples, Italy. Now, I was there during the holiday season and was able to enjoy some of the decorations that they had up around the city. Now, inside of the Galleria, mind you, this is essentially four identical buildings where they put a glass roof over the top. Each end of the four entrances is open air. If you look carefully, you can see that the Christmas ball in the middle of the image, the subject, is lined up with the lights across the glass archway behind it. Also, if you look at the circles in the marble floor, you can see I'm right in the middle. And even the lighting down the passageway on each side behind the Christmas ball seems to be symmetric. So this is a very good example of symmetry. Now, I'm going to show you an example where I failed. I moved a little bit here. And where I failed here in a couple different ways. Number one, the Christmas ball is not dead center in the image, and it does have a slight lean to it. Number two, take a look at the hallway on the right. It is clearly shorter than the hallway on the left, and you can see the end of the hallway on the right. And also because I'm not centered correctly, the angle in which both hallways dip down are different. And then something I didn't really notice while I was there, I should have but didn't, is if you take a look at the lighting on the hallway on the right-hand side towards the ground, you can see all those entryways are lit up, but on the left, they're not. So this image is just not as appealing to look at as the other. Now, you can achieve symmetry in nature, but you've got to be willing to be a little more relaxed with the rules. When it comes to nature, because we just don't have clean lines in nature like we do with man-made objects. Now, for example, this image of a lake. I really wish I could have got there before the lake had ripples in it. And if you wanted to do that, you generally have to be there right at sunrise before wind starts blowing on the water. But if you draw a line horizontally through the image, the reflection of the trees match the tree line that's above it. So we do have somewhat of a symmetric image here. Now, I knew though that the shoreline, because the shoreline is heading away from me in this image, it's not quite horizontal, but it's at least a somewhat of an example of how you can achieve symmetry in nature. Now, here is another one. This one I took in the Phoenix Sonoran Desert Preserve, and my goal here was to try and create a symmetric image with the mountain in the background. Now, if you look at the sorrel cactus in the lower third center of the image, you can see I've got it lined up with the peak of the mountain. Now, unfortunately, because the mountain just did not erode perfectly symmetric on the left and right, it didn't quite mirror itself exactly. But again, in nature, you've got to be willing to be a little flexible with the rules. Now, let's take a look at St. Peter's Basilica in Vatican City. So this is another good example of man-made symmetry. If you draw a line vertically down the middle of the screen, the left and the right line up, even to the statues on the lower left and the lower right of the screen. All right, so yeah, I am just slightly off-center, it looks like. Now, if you take a look at the bottom of the image, I'm not, but as you go up, there appears to be just a slight difference in where the dome should be lined up. But other than that, this is a pretty symmetric image. Now let's take a look at an image from Singapore. So I captured this image you're about to see on my last night there. So I was going everywhere I could in the city to try and photograph this amazing place. And then we stumbled on this. All right, so we're actually between two bridges. And you can see the symmetry here. This city is really put together well. Now, these two bridges are just, they've got perfect symmetry. And even better, I was able to do it at night with their lights on. This is a long exposure image, so I can kind of get that silky look in the water. And it was reflecting all the clean lines and light. So this is probably one of the most symmetric architectural images that I have ever taken. And I had a crowd watching me when I was capturing this. Seems like whenever I pull up the big camera, I get a crowd, but a lot of people were lining up with their cell phones as soon as I got away from the spot. So as a photographer, make sure you keep your eyes open because there was nobody photographing this when I walked up to it. Now here's another one from Singapore. Now these are just some shutters. This is taken in Chinatown. And it's using, again, another rule of composition as well, which is the rule of threes. We have three identical subjects in the image, but draw a line vertically down the middle, and you will see that they mirror each other, which adds to the appeal of the image. Now we can do the same thing here. This is from my trip to Washington, D.C. Cross the borders of Morocco. Take a journey to Dubai. Fight the pirates stuck in And this is an image of the U.S. Capitol Dome. And you can see that we have perfect symmetry on the left and right, with the exception of the American flag in the lower center of the image. Its pole is in the right place, but the flag moves off to the side. And that kind of ruins the symmetry just a tad. And yeah, I probably could have Photoshopped that one out, but I also kind of liked having it in the image. Now, here's another example of symmetry. This panorama that I took, if you look carefully, we are lined up straight with the statue of General Grant. The flagpole is right behind them, centered on the Capitol building. I had to get there early in order to get this particular spot, so another photographer would take it, because obviously this is the prime location to shoot the U.S. Capitol, at least with the reflecting pool in front of it. So the only thing that's really messing it up, if you look, the trees, of course, are not identical, and we should expect that. That's nature, so we should expect some deviation there. But also in the far right-hand corner, there's a little construction wall that kind of messed up the symmetry just slightly on the far edge of the image. Hey, everybody. Thank you for joining me today. I'm going to go get something warm in my stomach and get out of the cold here. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, and hit that notification bell. And also check out my bonus content on patreon.com/EWJ. There my patrons get free desktops, they get the locations of where I'm taking my images, and they even get some private behind the scene episodes as well. Y'all take care, and also if you could, remember to open your homes and your hearts to a shelter animal need, and if you can't, please donate to your local animal shelter. Y'all take care, and I'll see you in the next episode.